यस सर।
टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट स्टैटिस्टिक्स। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी। स्टिल नाउ वी नो दैट व्हाट इज ए रैंडम वेरिएबल एंड व्हाट इज इट्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन फंक्शन। It is generally seen that the value of the distribution function tend to cluster around a central value of the distribution. This tendency of distribution is called central tendency, and the major device to consider the tendency are called measure of central tendency. The average is a single value and it serves as a representative of distribution. Therefore, central tendency means the value of the distribution tend to a cluster around a central value of the distribution. This tendency is called central tendency, and its measure is called measure of central tendency. There are three kind of measures of central tendency: mean, median, and mode. There are three type of mean: arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. When we say simply a mean, that's mean we refer to the arithmetic mean. The arithmetic mean of a variable is derived by dividing the sum of its value by the number of the values. If the variable x takes the value x1, x2, dot, dot, xn, then its arithmetic mean is denoted by xi and defined by xi is equal to summation xi by n. I runs from 1 to n. This is the definition of arithmetic mean. Weighted arithmetic mean for ungrouped frequency. Is given by x pi is equal to summation fi xi by capital N, where capital N is the sum of all frequencies, that is summation fi, I runs from 1 to n. Fi is the frequency of the value of xi, that is how many times xi come in this observation. This number is denoted by fi. It is called as frequency in statistics. And the all outcome I not group here is ungrouped frequency. Weighted arithmetic mean for a group frequency distribution in the range x1 to x2, the frequency is f1. In the range x2 to x3, the frequency is denoted by f2. Then its weighted arithmetic mean is xi is equal to 1 by n summation fi mi. By mi is the middle point of this class interval xi to xi plus 1. Therefore, there are three types of arithmetic mean. properties came from the definition of the algorithm. This is simply the definition of this algorithm. Now we learn how to calculate algorithm by step division method. The example, calculate the admitting mean of the following data. This is example for grouped frequency. The marks is given by 0 to 10 and the number of student is 5. When the marks is 10 to 12, 20, then the student is 8. We write this question in the table format. This is an example of weighted arithmetic mean for group frequency distribution, because there is a given interval that the number when the number is 0 to 10 and the student is 5. Therefore, it is a group frequency distribution. Then we have to apply these definition of arithmetic mean. The arithmetic mean of weighted group frequency. For the interval 0 to 10, the midpoint is 5. This is denoted by M1. And F1, M1 is equal to 5 into 5, that's mean 25.
Sir, ekটু দেখুন তো কেউ জয়েন করতে চাচ্ছে কিনা মানে।
ঠিক আছে তো। আচ্ছা। As this is a question of group frequency, therefore the weighted arithmetic mean xy is equal to summation fi mi by capital M, where n is the total number of frequency. Here the total number of frequency is 50 and summation fi mi is equal to 1830. Therefore, x bar is equal to 1830 by 30. So here this is 50. This is printing mistake. This is the step how to find a weighted arithmetic mean for group frequency. There was alternative solution. We check this. There is another example. find the value of p if the mean of the distribution is 20. That the mean is given. We have to find the value of p. Here the total number of frequencies 5p plus 15. You can check this by adding the all frequencies. And summation fi xi is equal to 295 plus 100p plus 5p square. You can check this. As it is given that the mean is 20, therefore summation fi xi by capital N is equal to 20. After calculation, you can find that p is equal to plus minus 1. There are so many examples. You can check this. Now we study the central tendency, median. Median is the middlemost value of the variable in a distribution. Median is the middlemost value of the variable in a distribution. Mean was the average, and median is the middlemost value. For discrete variable without repetition, to find the median of a distribution, we first arrange the data either in ascending or in descending order of the values. If the number is odd, if the number of values is odd, then it can be written as 2n plus 1, by n is a natural number. And n plus 1th value is the median. If the number of the values is even, that is 2n, for any natural number n, then arithmetic mean of nth and n plus 1th value is the median. For this example, 30, 25, 24, here nth, n 20 is the nth value, and n plus 1th value is 70. Therefore, these two arithmetic mean of these two values is the median. Therefore, median is 20 plus 17 by 2, that is 18.5. This is the rule to find the median of a distribution for a discrete variable without repetition. When a distribution has ungrouped frequency, to find the median, we take the following step. Arrange the distribution either in ascending order or descending order. Then find n by 2, by n is the total number of frequency. Find cumulative frequency. In an example, we say that what is cumulative frequency. Then find the cumulative frequency just greater than n by 2. After that, the corresponding value of the variable is the median. It will be clear with an example. Consider this example. in the median of the following distribution. Here the income is 100, 150, 80, 200, 250, 180. And number of person is this example. The first step was arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Here we arrange the data in ascending order, like this table. 800, the income is all increases, and corresponding number of person is given in this root column 2. The cumulative frequency is for row 1 is 26. For row 2, it is addition of its corresponding frequency, which is 16, plus the corresponding frequency of the previous one, that is 26. This is called cumulative frequency. That is, in any row, to find the cumulative frequency, you have to add the current frequency with the previous one cumulative frequency. Here the total number of frequencies 122, therefore n by 2 is equal to 61. We have to find the just greater than the cumulative frequency just greater than 61. This is 66. And it corresponding incoming 150. Therefore, median is 150. First, we to solve this question, we have first arrange the given data in an ascending or descending order. After this, we have to find the cumulative frequency, and then we have to find the cumulative frequency just greater than n by 2, where n is the total number of frequency. And the corresponding income of the cumulative frequency just greater than n by 2 is our median. But the answer is 150. The previous one was for ungrouped frequency distribution. Now we find the median for a group frequency distribution. That is, the frequency is given for an interval. The formula is median for a group frequency distribution. The formula is median is equal to this one, L plus N by 2 minus C by F into H, where L is the lower limit of the median class. N is the total number of observation, F is the frequency of the median class, C is the cumulative frequency preceding class, and H is the class width. This is the formula for median of a group frequency distribution. It will be clear by an example. For this example, these are the given data, and this number of workers is the frequency, then cumulative frequency for the range 30 to 40 is 5, and for the range 40 to 50, the cumulative frequency is the addition of the current frequency, that is 3, plus the previous one commutative frequency, that is 5, that is equal to 8. Similarly, we can find all the commutative frequency for any interval. Here, the total number of frequencies is 45. Then n by 2 is equal to this one. Obviously, the class correspondent to correspondent frequency 28. As n by 2 is equal to 22, then the frequency just after n by 22 is 28, and the commutative frequency 28 belong to the class, to the interval class 50 to 60. Therefore, its lower bound is 50, length is 10, f is the frequency of that interval, that is 20, and c is the commutative frequency of the preceding class. The preceding class is 40 to 50, and its commutative frequency is 8, therefore c is equal to 8. Hence, the median can be found as the by this formula L plus N by 2 minus C by F into H. And this will be 57.25. Okay. This is another example of to find the median of group frequency distribution. You can check this. This is the last one of central frequency tendency. That is mode. Mode of a distribution is the value of the variable having maximum frequency. Mode of a distribution is the value of the variable having maximum frequency. It is called mode, maximum frequency. For example, calculate the mode of the following distribution. Here the x is the value of the distribution and f is the corresponding frequency. We can find that 28 is the maximum frequency and its corresponding values of the distribution is 3. Therefore, 3 is the mode of the distribution. This is the definition of mode. Mode of a distribution is the value of the variable having maximum frequency. The maximum frequency is 28. Therefore, the corresponding value of the distribution is 3. Hence, the mode is 3. For group frequency distribution, if f naught, f minus 1, f 1 represent the frequency of modal class means that this class in which the mode is contained, it's called modal class, and f minus 1 the class just preceding, and f 1 is the class just following it. For a group frequency distribution, the mode is defined as L1 plus this expression. L1 is the lower bound of the modal class. That is the lower bound of the class where the mode belongs to, and C is the common width of the classes. This is the definition of mode for a group frequency distribution. we can understand with this example. The example says the monthly profit in rupees of 100 shops are distributed as follows. Profit per shops and number of shops is given by second rule. We see that the largest class frequency is 27 and its corresponding interval or class is 200 to 300, and this is the modal class. Therefore, L1 is equal to 100, null limit of the modal class, and FQ is the frequency of the modal class, is 27. F minus 1 is the frequency of the previous one modal class. Previous of class of the modal class is 18, and F1 is equal to 20. The frequency of the class 300 to 400. Then we can calculate mode after putting this value. These three central tendency is related by formula. The approximate relation between mean, median, mode is given by mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. This relation between mean, median, and mode. This example says find the mode of the following distribution, which of all has already solved. We know how to find mode of a group frequency distribution. This example says to find the mean, median, and mode of the following data. This is a example of grouped frequency distribution, and we know how to calculate mean, median, and mode for a group frequency distribution. You can take this. Now we discuss about measure of dispersion. The dispersion is the measure of variation in the values of a variable. That means dispersion is the measure of variation of the values of a distribution function. The measure of degree of scattering scatteredness of the observation is the distribution around the central values. It measure of disruption, the scatteredness of the observation in a distribution around, that is mean, median and mode. There are mainly four types of measure of dispersion: the range, quartile dispersion, quartile deviation, mean deviation, and standard deviation. The range is the difference between two extreme observations of a distribution. That is, range of a distribution is equal to maximum value minus minimum value taken by the distribution. For example, if we consider this example, where match is represented by the first row, run of the batsman one is represented by second row, and run of batsman two represented by third row, then range of score of batsman one is maximum frequency of maximum score by batsman 1, which is 117, minus minimum score by batsman 1, which is 0. That is, therefore, range of score of batsman 1 is equal to 117. Similarly, we can find batsman 2. Basically, range on two extreme observations, so it does not measure the dispersion of the data from central values. Mean deviation is a mean deviation, divides a given data set into two equal halves. Similarly, a quartile I use to divide a given dataset into four equal halves. Therefore, there should be three quartiles for a given distribution, and the second quartile is equal to the median itself. The second quartile divides the data set into two equal halves, therefore it is a median. This is why the second quartile is the median of the distribution. The first quartile is denoted by Q1, correspond to the values that lies halfway between the median and the lowest value of the distribution. Q1 corresponds to the value that lies between lowest value of the distribution and between median. Similarly, third quartile corresponds to the value that lies halfway between the maximum value of the distribution and median. And third quartile is denoted by Q3. If we find Q1 and Q3, then the quartile deviation QD is defined by Q3 minus Q1 by 2. This is the formula to calculate quartile deviation. And the coefficient of quartile deviation is defined as Q3 minus Q1 by Q3 plus Q1 into 100. For a group data set, to find a quartile deviation, firstly we construct cumulative frequency table for the given data set. Then from the total number of data values, estimate the groups of the lower and upper quartiles. The lower quartile Q1 can be found by this formula, and the upper quartile Q3 is given by this formula, where LV is the lower bound of the class in which the respective quartile lies, H is the class width, FC is the cumulative frequency up to that class, and F is the frequency corresponding to the particular class. If we find Q1 and Q3, then we can find quartile deviation by the formula Q3 minus Q1 by 2. It will be clear from this example. Example says the number of vessels sold by major Toyota showroom in a day was recorded for 3 working days. The data is given by this: day 1, the total car sale, 20 total sale, and this. We have to find the quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation for the given discrete distribution. For this, we have to arrange the data set in a we have to find the sorry this is an example of this previous one. This is the step was for a group data set, but the example, this example is for discrete distribution function. For discrete distribution function, the first quartile can be found by n plus 1 by 4, where n is the total number of frequencies. Sorry, total number of data set. And Qt is given by 3 into n plus 1 by 4. Here n is 10 because there is 10 given data set. Therefore, quartile deviation is equal to Q3 minus Q1 by 2, and coefficient of quartile deviation is equal to Q3 minus Q1 by Q3 plus Q1 into 100. This is the example for a group frequency distribution. To find the quartile deviation, we have to find first the cumulative frequency, and we know that how to find the cumulative frequency. For the first class, the cumulative frequency is its own frequency. After that, The commutative frequency of a class is the addition of its own frequency and the previous class commutative frequency. Is the population of commutative frequency. Forty-five students. Similarly, the third quartile must lie at the position of n by four, three n by four. That is 135 students. The corresponding class is 20 to 30. Therefore, for first quartile, the lower bound is 20. And its depth is 10, its frequency is 30, that is f is 30, and fc is the frequency, commutative frequency of the previous class, that is the class 10 to 20, and whose commutative frequency is 30, therefore fc is equal to 30. We can calculate lower quartile or first quartile u1 by putting this value. Similarly, we can find the values of the upper quartile when u1 and q2 is obtained. Then we can find the quartile deviation by the formula q3 minus q1 by 2 and coefficient of quartile deviation by the formula q3 minus q1 by q3 plus q1 into 100. Now we talk about mean deviation. Therefore, we know what is range quartile deviation. Now we study about mean deviation. In this section, we will learn how to calculate mean deviation about the central measure of tendency mean and median for various type of data. The mean deviation for ungrouped data. Let x be the random variable and x1, x2, dot, dot, xn be its value. Then the mean deviation for an average, that is either median or mean, is given by mod of summation of mod of xi minus a is the average, that is mean or median, by n. This is the mean deviation. For example, calculate the mean deviation about median for the following data. Here, Here in this example, there is seven values of the random variable, which is odd. Therefore, its median is. Now, first we have to find median. First we have to arrange the given data set in a ascending order or descending order. Then clearly, middleest observation is 300, so median is 300. Then modulus of xi minus a, that is xi minus 300, we can find the value of di, and we know that mean deviation is equal to summation di by capital N. Or small n, sorry, small n, the total number of given data set. The mean deviation is equal to summation modulus xi minus a by capital, so small n. This is equal to 52.8. There is another example to find median around mean. Or median. This example, so calculate the mean deviation about mean of the following data. Then to solve this, we first have to find what is the mean of the following data. Then we have to find mean deviation, that is summation of modulus xi minus a, where a is the mean of the given data, by small a, the number of data. There are another example. The last deviation of distribution is variance. The variance of a variate x is the admitting mean of the square of all deviation of x from the admitting mean of the observation, and it is denoted by var x or sigma square. And the standard deviation is the positive square root of the variation x. This is the standard deviation. For an ungrouped observation, if x1, x2, dot, dot, to xn are n values of a variate x, then variance of the random variable x is defined as 1 by n into summation xi minus x bar, the whole square. I runs from 1 to n. I x bar is the mean of this given data set. Also, it can be written as variance of x is equal to 1 by n. Summation xi square minus 1 by n summation xi the whole square. This is the another expression of variance. This is for ungrouped frequency distribution. Find the variance and standard deviation of the following data. To find the variance, we have to find first the mean of the given data set. And mean is equal to summation xi by small n. Therefore, mean equal to 56. To find variance of x, we have to find xi minus x bar. And we know that now x bar is equal to 56. Therefore, we can find xi minus x bar for all I equal to 1 to here the number of data is whatever 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If xi minus x bar is calculated, then we can find xi minus x bar the whole square. Here n is equal to 10. And summation xi minus x bar the whole square is equal to 662. You can check this. Therefore, variance is equal to summation xi minus x bar the whole square by n. And standard deviation is equal to positive square root of variation. It will be 8.13. You can check this. Therefore, to find a variation of a given data set, first we have to find the mean of the given data set. Then we have to find the value of xi minus x bar for all I. After this, we have to find the summation xi minus x bar the whole square and the variance is equal to summation xi minus x bar the whole square by n. This is the formula for variation, and once variation is come out, then we can find standard deviation by taking positive square root of variation. There are several examples to find standard deviation and variance. Consider this example. Here there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 data set. Find the variance and standard deviation of the following frequency distribution. Here variable xi is given by the first column and frequency is given by second column. Therefore, we can find fi xi. Here the total frequency is 50. You can check this. Then we can find mean, which is summation fi xi by capital N. When mean is calculated, then we can find xi minus x bar. Then we can find the variation. The variation x is equal to summation fi xi minus x bar the whole square by n. Once variation is come out, then we can find standard deviation by taking positive square root of variation, and that will be equal to 3.88. You can check this. There are several examples on variation and standard deviation. There are a few exercise. In our next class, we discuss about bivariate analysis. আজ এ পর্যন্তই থাক। হ্যালো।
ওকে স্যার,
না
ওকে স্যার,
না, আমি যেটা বলছিলাম সেটা হচ্ছে তোমাদের একটু হয়তো অন্যরকম লাগবে, যে বোঝা না যেতে পারে, কিন্তু এখানে অ্যাকচুয়ালি বোঝার তেমন কিছু নেই আর কি, ক্যালকুলেশন শুধুমাত্র, ফর্মুলা ফর্মুলা ক্যালকুলেশন তোমরা দেখে নিয়ে একবার। অনেক এক্সাম্পল দিয়ে আছে, আশা করি এরকমই আশেপাশে এক্সাম্পল দিয়ে কোশ্চেন আসা উচিত, এরকম টাইপেরই আসা উচিত। এই এগুলো তোমাদের 12-এ ছিল?
কিছু কিছু ছিল, পুরো করিনি। সেই বাইবেরিটা আগে অব্দি ছিল,
ও তার মানে এগুলো ছিল সবগুলো যেগুলো বললাম।
বাইবেরিটা আগে অব্দি।
ঠিক আছে, তোমার দেখে নিও, হিউজ এক্সাম্পল দিয়ে আছে তো দেখে নিও, এগুলো অ্যাকচুয়ালি ক্যালকুলেশন, তাছাড়া কিছু না। ঠিক আছে, মনে হয় আমাদের আর একটা ক্লাসই লাগবে, বাকি তাহলে শেষ হয়ে যাবে আর কি। তোমাদের কবে থেকে কত তারিখ থেকে পরীক্ষা?
জানা যায়নি কিছু এখনো।
ও ঠিক আছে, দেখা যাক কয়েক কত দিন লাগে।